बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू एपसेक्स ऑनलाइन सपोर्ट प्रोग्राम। आई एम बीनिश आसिफ फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बायोलॉजी, गर्ल्स सीनियर विंग, एपसेक, फोर्ट रोड, रावलपिंडी। टुडे वी हैव लेक्चर नंबर टू ऑफ वीक फोर, दैट इज़ फ्रॉम चैप्टर नंबर 16, स्पोर्ट एंड मूवमेंट, एंड द पेज नंबर ऑफ टेक्स्ट बुक आर पेज नंबर 52 एंड पेज नंबर 53। These are the pages of textbook, that is page number 52 and 53, which we are going to discuss in today's lesson. So, topic of today's lesson is disorders of skeleton, and you can see different disorders of skeleton in humans. Disorders of skeleton. Before discussion of skeletal disorders in detail, we have to know about skeletal deformation. What does this mean? Skeletal deformation, as its name indicates, is the distortion of bones or skeleton. So we can define it as structural deviation of the bone's shape from its normal alignment, length and size. इसका मतलब ये है कि जब भी bone की shape के अंदर उसकी normal size से, length से जो भी change आएगी, उन size changes को हम क्या कह रहे हैं कि bone deform हो रही है, और वो क्या है, skeletal deformation. What are different types of skeletal deformation? It may be acquired, which a person gets during its lifetime, or it may be congenital, which a person gets by birth, and congenital is also known as the hereditary. So what are different skeletal disorders, which are the examples of acquired and hereditary skeletal deformation? The example of hereditary skeletal deformation is arthritis, while the acquired skeletal deformation may be of different types. First is hormonal, and the example of hormonal skeletal deformation is osteoporosis, which you can see in the diagram. And second is due to nutritional deficiency, and the example of this type of skeletal deformation is the osteomalacia indicates. These both are the bone disease in which bones become weak and bow under pressure. Common skeletal disorders. Common skeletal disorders are: number 1, slip disc or herniated disc; number 2, spondylosis; number 3, sciatica; and number 4 is the arthritis. Slip disc or the herniated disc, and the diagram given below shows the herniated disc. Slip disc or the herniated disc, as its name indicates, that during it a disc may be slipped. And now question arises whether it is entire disc or the part of disc that slips. To understand it, first we have to know about the intervertebral disc. Now, what is intervertebral disc? The word disc represents a layer of, or means a layer of cartilage. And as it is intervertebral disc, so inter mean between, and vertebral mean vertebrae. So a layer of cartilage that is present between the two successive vertebrae of the spine is known as the intervertebral disc. What is the significance of this layer of cartilage between the two successive vertebrae of spine? It acts as cushion like pad, so it prevents the spine during any injury or trauma and reduces pressure on it. Now, what is the structure of intervertebral disc? It consists of two main parts, an inner part and an outer part. The inner part is known as the nucleus pulposus, and the outer part is known as the annulus fibrosus. In the diagram, you can see the inner part, which consists of a semi-fluid, and this semi-fluid inner part is the nucleus pulposus. Now, what is the significance of this semi-fluid inner part? It acts as a rubber ball to give a disc its elasticity and compressibility. The outer part, which is known as the annulus fibrosus, it is a hard ring, and this hard ring is made up of fibrocartilage. And what is the significance of this hard fibrocartilage part? It holds the two successive vertebrae together, and it also acts as the shock absorber during any injury and trauma. It protects the spine. Now, what are the causes of slip disc, severe or sudden trauma to spine? In the diagram, you can see spinous processes, which are the extension of the extension the posterior part, and these extensions are used for the attachment of muscles, for extension, bending, etc. What happens during slip disc or the herniated disc? Now we have to observe what are the changes that takes place in the intervertebral disc which change these discs into the slipped or herniated disc. So the herniated disc or slipped disc usually involves, number one, rupture of annulus fibrosis. So it means that in the first step, the hard outer part of the intervertebral disc, that is annulus fibrosis, it gets ruptured, or it may be teared. Now how it gets ruptured, or what are the factors that are responsible for rupturing or tearing of annulus fibrosis, these include any accident, any injury, lifting a heavy object, or sitting in the same posture for several hours. So all these factors can cause rupturing of annulus fibrosis. Now what happens next? Jaise hi annulus fibrosis jo hai, iske andar होल बनेगा, ये रप्चर होगी. इसके साथ ही जो अंदर वाला पार्ट है, इनर पार्ट, न्यूक्लियस पल्पोसिस, वो जो सेमी फ्लूइड है, इट बिगिंस टू फ्लो आउटसाइड, तो वो बाहर की तरफ फ्लो करना स्टार्ट कर देगा. सो व्हाट हैपेंस इन द सेकंड स्टेप, रप्चर इज़ फॉलोड बाय द प्रोट्रूजन ऑफ स्पॉन्जी न्यूक्लियस पल्पोसिस. नाउ जैसे ही ये न्यूक्लियस पल्पोसिस बाहर आएगा, तो ये प्रेस करता है स्पाइनल कॉर्ड को और स्पाइनल नर्व्स को. अगर ये प्रेस करेगा हार्डली, तो उसकी वजह से क्या है, इट कॉज पेन, और पेन के साथ साथ समटाइम्स इट कैन इवन cause destruction of the nervous structure. So if protrusion passes on the spinal cord or on the spinal nerves, it generates wear, pain, and even destruction of the nervous structure. So what are the main reasons for the herniated disc? It is rupture of annulus fibrosis, then flow of annulus pulposis, and then pressing of the spinal nerves or spinal cord, or even destruction of the nervous structures. Now the question which we have discussed in the start, that whether it is the entire disc or the part of disc which is slipped. So slip disc is misleading, as it is not the whole disc that slides out of the position. As we had discussed above, that it is only a small part of the nucleus pulposus that bulges out, and it is responsible for the pain of the spinal cord. As in the diagram, you can see all the changes that takes place in the normal disc, and change it into the herniated disc by bulging of nucleus pulposus. When nucleus pulposus flow out, तो उसके बाद ये क्या है, material के निकलने से disc degenerate हो जाएगी. Second skeletal disorder is the spondylosis. Spondylosis. What does spondylosis means? It means degenerative process which affects the vertebral disc. As vertebral discs are affected, there is a fusion of the two successive vertebrae, and there will be no movement. So it becomes hard, and it is very painful condition of spine due to the degeneration of the intervertebral disc. Or we can also say that spondylosis is the immobility and fusion of the vertebral joint, because due to the absence of intervertebral disc, the vertebral joints fuse together and they don't allow any type of movement. So this condition is known as the spondylosis. Effects of spondylosis: it mainly affects the spinal cord. How it affects the spinal cord? It narrows the spinal canal, compress the spinal cord, and as it narrows and compress the spinal cord, the pressure on spinal cord increases, which causes pain. And next, what are the causes of cervical spondylosis? The main causes of cervical spondylosis are, as the word cervical represents the neck vertebrae. So the main causes are, number one, chronic cervical degeneration, number two, herniation of disc, and number three is aging. Among these, the main cause of spondylosis is aging, as it is the degenerative process. So in the diagram, you can see the symptoms of cervical spondylosis, and in the second diagram, the herniated invertebral disc caused the spinal cord compression. It is a painful process which is due to the compression of the spinal cord. Third skeletal disorder is the sciatica, or we can also say it is sciatica, which you can see in the diagram. Sciatica, what is sciatica? आप लोगों ने डेली लाइफ में भी ऑब्जर्व किया होगा कि लोगों को अक्सर ये छाटिका का दर्द होता है, जिसमें उनकी कमर से दर्द स्टार्ट होता है और पूरी टांग में जाता है। तो इस दर्द को कहते हैं कि ये कौन सा दर्द है छाटिका का, अब इसकी रीज़न क्या है, कॉजेस क्या हैं और इसमें कौन से एरियाज़ हैं जो अफेक्ट होते हैं, वो आज हमने डिस्कस करने हैं। सो व्हाट इज़ छाटिका? इट रेफर्स टू द पेन अफेक्टिंग बैक, हिप एंड आउटर साइड ऑफ द लेग by the compression of spinal nerve root in the lower back due to the degenerative intervertebral disc. So it means that three regions kaun se hain? Ek lower back, these are affected, lower back, hip region and the leg. As you can see in the diagram which is given below, that three region, lower back, hip and leg जो है उसकी outer side जो है it is affected. अब ये किस वजह से अफेक्ट होगी कि इसमें मेन रीज़न जो है वो जब लोअर बैक में इंटरवर्टिब्रल डिस्क डीजेनरेट होगी देन इट कंप्रेसेस द स्पाइनल नर्व रूट. जब वो स्पाइनल नर्व रूट कंप्रेस होती है तो इट कॉज द पेन. और पेन किन रीजन्स में रेडिएट करता है? एक तो लोअर बैक में, हिप रीजन में एंड द लेग. सर्टिका आल्सो रेफर्स टू पेन, वीकनेस, नमनेस और टिंगलिंग इन द लेग. The pain causes numbness and which is also responsible for weakness, and tingling means it causes prickling sensation in the leg. So three main regions are affected by sciatica, that is lower back, hip region and the outer part of the leg. So what are the causes of sciatica? There are many causes of sciatica. Number one, pressure on the sciatic nerve. As you can see in the diagram, the sciatic nerves that arises from the lower back and it goes along the entire length of the leg. But when it is compressed due to the degenerative intervertebral disc, it causes pain which radiates in the three regions. Next is injury, slip disc, pelvic injury, fracture and tumors. In the second diagram, you can see the slip disc causes the compression of spinal nerve and cause pain. Fourth and last skeletal disorder is arthritis. And you can see different types of arthritis in the diagram given below. Arthritis is the inflammation of joints and it causes stiffness. What are the other symptoms of arthritis? These are number one, pain after walking, which may later occur even at rest. Number two is creaking sounds in the joints. Creaking sounds is tarah ki hoti hai ki jab koi is tooti hai usko hum move kare usse jo awaazein hain, that sound is the creaking sound. To joints se us tarah ki awaazein aati hain. Number three is difficulty in getting up from a chair. And number four is pain on walking up and down stair. Upar niche aane jaane mein bhi, kyunki wo joints jo unme inflammation hoti hai, swelling hogi aur pain bhi hota hai, jiske wajah se chalne firne mein zyada movement mein difficulty hogi. You can see in the diagram inflammation and pain in the joints of vertebral column, hand joint, foot joint, knee joint and hip joint, etc. Types of arthritis. There are three different types of arthritis. Number one is osteoarthritis. Number two is rheumatoid arthritis. Number three is gouty arthritis. So we will discuss one by one these three types. Number one is osteoarthritis. What happens during osteoarthritis? The cartilage that is present or that covers the ends of bones at joint, it becomes softened and then disintegrated. And when this cartilage is disintegrated, then the two bones fuse and they don't allow any type of movement and cause pain. So it is a progressive disease in which the articular cartilage is gradually softened and disintegrate. What are the regions that are affected by osteoarthritis? These are knee, hip and intervertebral joints. So in the diagram you can see the difference between a healthy joint having cartilage and the joint which has osteoarthritis, in which cartilage and bone is damaged, and due to the degeneration of the cartilage, the two bone fuse and cause swelling and pain. Second type of arthritis is the rheumatoid arthritis. And it results from an autoimmune disorder. What is the meaning of autoimmune disorder? That in this, the body's own immune system destroys the synovial membrane or takes a synovial membrane, due to which it becomes inflamed. So unlike osteoarthritis, which is the aging disorder, it is autoimmune disorder. Symptoms: synovial membrane becomes inflamed due to the faulty immune system, and when synovial membrane becomes inflamed, synovial fluid becomes accumulated in it, and it causes swelling and inflammation, which causes pain. As you can see in the diagram, in different joints, rheumatoid arthritis causes pain and inflammation due to the accumulation of the synovial fluid. Third type of arthritis is the gouty arthritis. Unlike osteo and rheumatoid arthritis, it is a metabolic disorder, and during it, an abnormal amount of uric acid is retained in the blood. As we all know that uric acid is produced in the body by the breakdown of purines. When these chemicals are broken down, uric acid is formed in the blood, and it is a waste product which is excreted from the body through blood. But when we take food high in protein, then this uric acid is accumulated in the body in the form of crystals in joints, and it causes pain and swelling and inflammation. So it causes gouty arthritis. So an abnormal amount of uric acid is retained in the blood. Sodium urate crystals are deposited in the joints, and the regions which are affected by gouty arthritis are the big toe joint, as you can see in the diagram. So that's the end of today's lesson. Let's have a recap of topics. So what we have discussed in today's lesson, that is disorders of skeleton, and the different disorders are: number one, slip disc, which is also known as the herniated disc, and number two is spondylosis, number three is sciatica, and number four is arthritis. And three types of arthritis, that is osteoarthritis, rheumatoid arthritis, and the gouty arthritis. So that's the end of today's lesson. You have to complete a short question number 15, and part H and I of question number 24 on loose sheets, and you have to learn the entire topic covered in this lecture.